This is where I live, in a world with over 7 billion people on it, and there is only one person with my cultural identity.
What I mean by cultural identity is what from my culture, race, customs, beliefs, environments make me, me.
This is me. And I guess I should have started off with my name so you know who you're talking to. Well, who's talking to you? My name is Clarice, and though you may not be able to tell, I am primarily African American and Puerto Rican. I grew up predominantly around the African American side of my family, which is my mom's side of the family. This is my mom. Don't worry though, I can pull out the Puerto Rican side when I want to. Now that we have that preliminary stuff out of the way, let's get started. This is my huge family, so huge that we couldn't all fit in one picture, and predominantly African American, as you can see. The African American culture is comprised of many different things. One of the most recognizable aspects of the African American culture is faith or religion. I am a Christian. I grew up in church, Sunday services, prayer meetings, praise and worship, everything. Though I still attend, it is not as often as in my childhood or as I probably should. Talking about my religion makes me think about another aspect of my culture that is hugely important and a favorite for most people. Food. Growing up, we have the typical Sunday dinner, which is why the religion and the food connect for me. Soul food, and no, not the movie, is what many African American families cooked. So think fried chicken, candied yams, greens, black eyed peas, neck bones, peach cobbler, gumbo. Okay, that's enough of that. I'm getting kinda hungry. But wait. This also brings me to another side of my culture, Puerto Rican. The food, also so good. Think penne, arroz con habichuelas, pasteles, gandules, bacalao. And again, that is enough because I'm making you and me hungry now. Since we're talking about my Puerto Rican side right now, let's talk about the language and the fact that I can kind of speak but understand a lot more of the one of the most popular languages in the world, Spanish. Soy un puertorriqueña y yo solo hablo un poco de español, pero estoy bien con eso. Thank you, High School Spanish, for helping me piece that together. Okay, enough of me fumbling through that Spanish. Now it's time to get to something that everybody knows about. Music. My choice in music is, let's say, eclectic. My playlists can range from many different genres. An example of this is R&B. Like the way you work it, jump tight all day, every day. You're blowing my mind, maybe in time, baby, I can get you in my ride. I like the way you work it, no diggity. I got to bag it up. Bag it up. And the next song could be country. You be my soft and sweet, I'll be your strong and steady. You be my glass of wine, I'll be your shot of whiskey. You be my sunny day, I'll be your shade tree. You be my honeysuckle, I'll be your honeybee. Don't forget about the salsa. And of course, some hip hop. You wake up, post up, run around in it, blossom on it. This diamond, my diamond, this rock, my rock,
My playlist will even include a sudden Elmo's Ducks that I forgot was there for my little cousin. Some of my choices in music are typical because of my culture, like the hip-hop, which most associate with African-American, and the salsa, which most associate with Spanish culture. But we can go from A to Z in my music and keep finding something different. We're gonna move on to physical appearance now, which is how most people figure out what you are anyway. I know I don't look the most African-American, though many people can tell, and I don't look very Puerto Rican either, but I'm a mix, so it's not surprising. My fashion is pretty mainstream, and my hair could be anything. From bone straight or big and curly, natural, what most people associate with African American, braided and different colors. My mannerisms vary, mostly depending on my attitude, but if I'm angry, you can see that stereotypical neck roll come out. No matter what you see on the outside, my cultural identity is much deeper. I'm not trying to get all philosophical, believe me, but I am a cultural iceberg, and you can thank Freud for that reference.